Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Before we get started, I would like to thank the organizer of this wonderful meeting for inviting me to speak here today. I will be talking about dark and photoconductivity or the rate of charge nanocrystal. We'll discuss several theoretical design principles of creation of nanocrystal solid, which could provide high conductivity. The result you will hear about today was obtained mainly with Steve Irwin. With Steve Irwin, and published in this paper, and our research was supported by use of Orville research. The first order ray of nanocrystal solid was created by 28 years ago by Chris Murray, at that time in Bavendi lab. Here is CTM image of FCC solid of 6 nanometer identical castellanite nanocrystal. And this paper contained a great promise because potentially you can create artificial material with novel unknown in the nature property due to variety of the nanocrystal shape, size, and composition. However, this property, this promise was not realized and still has not realized because nanocrystals in this solid practically don't talk to each other and essentially present van der Waal crystal with a little variation of their property. However, some progress in this direction was achieved during last years. Electron mobility inside solid increased by 5 orders of magnitude, and Sherry Cogan reported mobility 27 centimeter was volt second at room temperature. This achievement was a result of decreasing the distance between nanocrystals, changing the organic legal, replacing by inorganic legal, changing capping layer. But this value already suggests strong coupling between nanocrystal information of three-dimensional electron bands. So in my talk, I will discuss how this electron conductivity and mobility depend on organic legal molecule and ion that perceive nanocrystal surface, as well describe magnitude of the dark current mobility, a surprisingly high photoconductivity in this structure, as well as some other aspects of photoconductivity in this structure. Let's start our analysis with a solid state effective mass approach. In this approach, each quantum dot presented potential well, which in simple case arranged in cubic lattice structure with period B. In our calculation, we assume that this potential has form of Wood-Saxon potential, where U0 is equal to nanocrystal ionization threshold, has a radius A, and parameter lambda is introduced to smooth the abrupt interface connected with atomic structure is on the order interatomic distance. Electron is this periodic potential acting sum of all this potential. And for Wood-Saxon potential, this potential can be written as sum of the Fourier component of Wood-Saxon potential over all receptor vector of cubic lattice. As we know, according to Bloch theorem, electron moves through this periodic potential as quasi-free particle, where wave vector determines the accuracy of reciprocal vector of cubic lattice. And the structure leads to formation of some band, which exists below ionization threshold and above ionization threshold. So for lowest band dispersion, we can find, we can use tight binding approximation, which got following distortion for cubic lattice structure, where T is so-called Hopping integral proportional to ionization threshold and overlap integral between two electron localized neighboring quantum dot, which I show schematically here. And straightforward calculation shows that this overlap integral exponentially depends on the distance between quantum dot B minus 2A and reach maximum when nanocrystals touching each other. The critical parameter in this expression is decay wave function under the barrier region. The additional shift of ground state energy connected with interaction between the ascending crest also proportional to the overlap integral. The bandwidth in such cubic structure is equal to 12 Hopping integral and reached maximum when overlap integral reached maximum when nanocrystal touching each other. And here I show how this maximum bandwidth depends on nanocrystal radius for cut selenide quantum dots. You see at nanocrystal radius 1.5, the bandwidth can be as large as 300 MeV if the band offset is not very large. At the bottom of this band, electron has parabolic dispersion, and this effective band can be expressed through band of this tight binding calculation band. It is, can be very large if band is narrow. This will lead to carrier localization, but in a structure with large subband, this effective mass can be significantly smaller than mass of free electron. So let's calculate mobility of the carrier in this subband. This mobility strongly depends on the ratio of band and temperature. In the case when temperature much larger, much smaller than band width, and carrier occur in the parabolic part of electron spectra, we can use standard expression for calculation of this mobility from any handbook of quantum of solid state. And we calculated this scattering transport time, connected it with fluctuation of nanocrystal size position and their radius. So as a result, the scattering transport rate proportional to chi square, which proportional fluctuation of nanocrystal radius and displacement, is proportional to effective mass and momentum. And for degenerate electron gas, when a Fermi level is larger than temperature, mobility can be easily calculated, substituting this scattering transport time as a Fermi level, and where as a non-degenerate electron gas, again using standard transport theory for parabolic band, you can get expression for mobility of carrier, which again exponentially depend on the distance of nanocrystal at reach maximum when nanocrystal touching each other. At the maximum, this maximum mobility depends on the temperature like 1/tau to the 1/2. And here I show you mobility as a function of nanocrystal radius calculated 300, calculated at 300 Kelvin. Again, you can see that mobility indeed in small nanocrystal can reach values 30. So in all these cases, mobility strongly depends on overlap integral. It is goes like power s to the power 2/2. Finally, at a very high temperature, when temperature larger than bandwidth, temperature enters into the kinetic equations only through derivative of Boltzmann function, and where n a concentration of carrier, and n a concentration of nanocrystal, and for all electron derivative gives the same expression, inversely proportional to temperature, and get mobility inversely proportional to temperature and proportional to the Hopkins integral. Here I plot you temperature dependence of the mobility calculated in different path. So when Fermi level larger than temperature, then decaying like 1√T, then 1/T. This calculation was conducted assuming the carrier concentration is the same as the band. However, not what was done in Sherry-Kagan experiment. The carrier concentration increases with temperature due to local ionization of shallow defect at nanocrystal surface. And so this curve qualitatively similar to what Sherry observed in her experiment. Finally, if you don't have band, Hopping conductivity and mobility also described by overlap integral. This is a very critical parameter for all transport property in all nanocrystal lattices. Now, question arises.
And the limit of the
Sorry? Yes, correct. I'm sorry. So does a solid model have any value? Because we know that nanocrystal solid is created in the organic matrix which passivates nanocrystal surface. So to answer this question, we use density function theory to calculate overlap integral and reveal how electrons spans depend on the ligand. So for this calculation, we use a model of three-dimensional cubic lattice with well-defined facet nanocrystal of identical size and shape. In this case, chemical type and length of organic ligand, their density, mutual interaction nanocrystal radius collectively determines Zeta's constant D, shown here. Further simplified model of cubic nanocrystal solid, we consider the company represented by closest possible contact between opposite ligand coming from opposite facet. We further simplified our calculation, replacing nanocrystal solid by nanoplatelet solids. And this periodic infinite nanoplet, whose surface orientation corresponds to opposite facet nanocrystal solid, and this simplified model captures three important features: quantum size effect in the nanocrystal, the type of size of ligand-ligand-ligand interaction, as well as length spacing in nanocrystal solid. So we investigated cat-selenide nanoplate with carboxylate chain ligand. And here I show you an example for monolayer nanoplate of cat-selenide passivate actinic ligand. Here the different ions show atoms are shown by different colors: cadmium, selenium, oxygen, carbon, and hydrogen. And here I show relaxed low energy ligand coordination obtained from DFT, total energy calculation, in which COA head group is coordinated with surface cadmium ion. The DFT calculation show that the attachment of the head group is a hybrid of bridging, shown here, and chelating type of connection, and it is a result of DFT calculation. So coupling determined by overlap integral, and here I show you the quantum size level function in two nanoplatelet calculated using DFT is hybrid screen exchange. The wave function is average along nanoplatelet surface. And in this case, overlap integral is just one-dimensional integral. And here I show how the overlap integral for this carboxylate chain ligand depends on the length of the ligand. You see all these different axial chain ligand sitting on the same exponential function. And I believe it is very important result, which shows that all these ligands have the same unique potential barrier, and electron tunneling through this barrier, which is thickness determined by length of ligand. We compare also our theoretical result with experimental data on the nanocrystal solid created with different material, but with the same type of ligand. And here I show the result of extracting overlap integral, also described by a single exponential function. And the property of ligand of the nanocrystal solid doesn't play a role because it is gold, it is last selenide, and a kappa sulfide. It's kappa sulfide. So the decaying integral is very insensitive to the solid state material which nanocrystal solid is created. To confirm the result, we also calculated decay overlap integral for two monolayer cat-selenide nanoplatelet shown here. And again, decay is practically the same for all this material. This shows that all this ligand can be considered as effective media with quite large potential barrier. And electron in order to overlap should tunnel through this barrier, which can be well determined. So this comes. Yeah.
Situations of the pagans, which
You will give me the additional 10 minutes? You already take my 5 minutes. So you see here, we decided to analyze it back to effective mass theory. So here I show you step square well model where we try to use to describe the DFT calculation shown here by the red curve. It is wave function for formula acetylenate nanoplate passivated by actinate ligand average in the plane. And this blue curve show effective wave function for step square well potential that best reproduces DFT wave function in the least square sense. And this calculation shows that in the ligand area, barrier is 1 electron V, and between ligand is 4.2 EV. So now let's come using this effective square well potential to calculate overlap integral. And here I show typical wave function calculated to this potential, where overlaps come from the decaying in the ligand region. And substituting this expression, we obtain this blue curve. We show effective mass calculation for overlap integral in such structure. It's very close to what we obtain in DFT calculation. This decay line are very similar because all these ligands are all CH2 and saturated carbon chain. But the real parameter question is, why is this decay length does not depend on the nanocrystal material or nanocrystal size? And to answer this question, let's come back to textbook problem, behavior of electron wave function in single quantum well. It decays in the barrier, and decay described by this function, where different between potential barrier and lowest quantum confined level. Energy of level can be found from this root of this transcendental equation. A first solution of this equation gives us energy of level. As well, we can obtain the decay length. It is expression of first order correction. You see this decay is mainly controlled by potential barrier. As a small correction connected with typical size of nanocrystal or nanoplatelet in this case, but parameter is much smaller than you expect, because in this parameter is the effective mass of electron in the barrier, which is much larger than the effective mass of electron in the quantum well. This is why this correction unexpected small, and that is why result of our DFT calculation and experimental data shows that so low in sensitivity indicate to the property of nanocrystal solid. So I show you the mobility bandwidth control by overlap integral, and this overlap integral is very small in nanocrystal solid created in organic molecule which passivate nanocrystal surface due to large band offset in singular ligand interface. It is clear that there is a good idea to grow nanocrystal solid in semiconductor, where band offset between semiconductor several orders, 3 times, 5 times, smaller than a ligand. Especially good for this is perovskite, because they have very soft lattice. And in principle, this would allow you to match lattice constant of the nanocrystal structure to the lattice constant of the matrix. And on the top of this, lead sulfide, lead selenide material has lattice constant very close to perovskite material. And indeed, it was shown by a successful growth of lead sulfide nanocrystal solid in perovskite matter, in MAPI matrix, in Sergent group, the conductivity of the structure quite high. So we decided to check this result and make calculation of two 2.4 nanometer diameter lead sulfide nanocrystal embedded sodium lead iodide matrix. The calculation was conducted in order to relax all ion position and determine the band offset between lead sulfide and sodium lead iodide nanocrystal. The period of this supercell was selected 5.1 nanometer. And here I show the relaxed position of all ions you can see in this enhanced picture. There is a significant shift. The supercell size was selected using known DFT lattice quantum cesium lead iodide. And totally, supercell contained 2,768 atoms, so calculation of the supercell took 3 months. Yeah. So here I show the distribution of distance of relaxed position between lead and sulfide and lead iodide. 2 peaks, one connected with quantum dot and second connected with matrix. And this, you see the average position of this spacing is practically very close to average position of DT calculated spacing in bulk lead sulfide. And for spacing between lead and iodide, the spacing is focused around distance between lead and iodide in the bulk cesium lead iodide. This calculation clearly indicates that lead sulfide nanocrystal and matrix try to hold the lattice constant of the bulk material. And this is clear consequence of the soft character of the perovskite lattice. So in light of all this calculation, we calculated natural offset of the valence band for lead sulfide and cesium lead iodide and determined band offset of conduction band by adding energy gap. And here you see exact offset which we calculated during this 3 months calculation. So you see that in both cases, lead sulfide doesn't keep electron inside. Contrast to the claim of Sergeant Group that it is type 1 heterostructure. In order to get this type 1 heterostructure, we need to pull down the bottom of conduction band. It can be done by adding some organic molecule to the surface of lead sulfide nanocrystal, as it was shown by in Bavendi group, which can shift this bottom up to 2 electron volt. In our calculation, we demonstrated that halogen can, on the surface of lead sulfide nanocrystal, can play this role. We shift the bottom of conduction band down. Here is the result of our calculation of the electrostatic shift, which halogen provides. It depends clearly on halogen coverage. It is all component practically gives the same share for all for small coverage of the surface, and it can be, this result can be easy qualitatively understand because halogen is very charge negative. It drag electron from surface of lead sulfide to the surface to have double layer, which create electric field, which magnitude proportional to degree of coverage. And then it is large electric field. The electric field polarize halogen and create dipole, which has opposite direction. So as a result, you have such saturated dependence of electric field and saturated dependence of stock shift, of the shift. So I told you the line width control conductivity of the material. And this line width can be calculated for one-dimensional structure using chronic Penny model. And here I show an example of such calculation of chronic Penny, which show dispersion, analytical dispersion you can get for parabolic band. And this is line width. In lead sulfide nanocrystals, the conduction band and valence band are non-parabolic. That is why you need to count dependence of effective mass. So in order to describe this effect, we calculated, developed coupled chronic Penny model, which take into account non-parabolicity of electron and hole effective mass, and we're able to calculate band width in lead sulfide cesium lead iodide superstructure. And here how this band width depends on parameter and potential barrier for different parameters of this super lattice and quantum dot diameter. You see band become broader if nanocrystal size is smaller and the potential barrier is smaller. Clear obvious result. And here I show you how a bandwidth of electron holes are bent in DOT and perovskite as a function of coverage of halogen atom absorbed by quantum DOT. This vertical line shows the limit of effect of this coverage because the shift is much larger than energy gap of cesium light iodide. And this vertical line show area where both electron and hole are localized in lead sulfide nanocrystal. Such calculation is important because for light emitting diode or laser, you need to have equal conductivity, both conduction and valence band. And that is why you want to have more or less similar type band because it depends strongly on the band. Finally, I would like to say a couple of words about photoconductivity. Here I show a result for comparison dark conductivity, photoconductivity of supercell of castellanite calcium core shell nanocrystal. You see photoconductivity currently is two orders of magnitude larger than dark conductivity and can be easily understood using simple expression for the current, where first contribution connected with resident carrier, a second contribution connected with photo-excited carrier. If mobility of the photo-excited carrier much larger than mobility of resident carrier, you can get such dramatic increase despite the fact the concentration of photo-excited carrier is smaller. This phenomenon actually about increase of photoconductivity was known in disorder semiconductor. How nanocrystal embedded glass matrix or polymer has specific properties. They show well-defined ionization threshold, which can be measured. And clearly you have resident electron which move in this potential well, and nearly free electron which move above ionization threshold, which mobility is much larger. And we calculate this mobility using the same model of distortion of the lattice, the position and scattering, and found this mobility for electron with energy 2 electron volt is 100 times larger than for ground exciton level, electron level. So there are four mechanisms for creating such highly excited, almost free electron. Each mechanism depends on the frequency of excitation. The first connected with direct excitation electron hole above this ionization threshold. Second mechanism is direct nanocrystal ionization, so you take electron valence band, eject it above the threshold. Finally, it is Ag ionization nanocrystal, photon larger than band gap create electron in the almost continuous spectra as a result of annihilation of this electron hole pair. And smallest photon could directly ionize electron hole from lowest level of quantum dot to conduction band. The Ag rate in nanocrystal is much larger than the rate of radiative recombination. As a result, quasi-free carrier generates almost 100% probability if you get inside nanocrystal. And we found strong confirmation of our model. Existing psi highly mobile carrier created by photon in this paper, which study frequency dependence of photoconductivity lead sulfide nanocrystal solid. This photoconductivity shows several peaks, and we believe they can identify it, each peak with some mechanism of nanocrystal ionization. First peak at 0.9 electron volt, connected with direct photoexcitation of hole in this case above ionization threshold. Second peak, connected with 1.5 electron volt, can be explained by geoionization of nanocrystal. And addition to resonant excitation of this nanocrystal, there is some non-resonant of excitation of this nanocrystal. There is a additional broad BAMP at 2.2 electron volt, which can be connected with direct ionization of nanocrystal. And finally, with some ionization, you can assume that this peak at 3.3 could be created by photon with created simultaneously electron and hole above threshold. With this I conclude. It's my summary, but I will be answering any question you have.
Thank you,
you
Sasha.
You took 5 minutes from me.
You were on time. You're good. I was told the next session would be problematic, but I have some plans. Victor.
Yeah, then Sasha, I'm not going to argue your interpretation of our data. Guys, just it's completely different. Okay, just read the paper. Sasha, question regarding this analysis of the effect of the ligand length theory versus experiment. Like you showed us net loss paper, and yeah, that was not ordered solid. So it was actually some spin cast material, definitely not ordered. So the question: so how basically you considered your chronic Penny model, which is requires periodicity, etc., and then experimentally we deal with largely amorphous fields. So there is no order, quantum dot size is different, ligands kind of also, the spacing is different. So how that actually can translate, how you translate your theory to this very correct question.
Yes, that is absolutely very correct question. But there is clear there are no order array in, say, mode paper. But there is average distance, which can be selected for the coupling between this ligand. And propagation of current goes not through all possible distance. It's between this optimal distance, which would provide us two ligand. And I believe it is how its conductivity depends on the ligand length. So you have some quantum dot which on the double ligand distance, and this provides you current. So it's kind of percolation through this cluster. It's how we think it.
Okay. So I think, yeah, kind of hopping regime probably is not that. Pretty much Matt looked at room temperature.
Yes.
Right? And that's your hopping regime, 1 over T. Maybe that then, you know, the
requirement. Well, in the hopping regime, it's not going to be that
I don't think it's an ordered array or not.
Because when you're hopping, you just hop to the nearest neighbor.
Yeah, Victor, we calculate, we don't calculate conductivity formation band in the this case. We can see the overlap integral in this case. And the overlap created by critical cluster where nanocrystals at least touching each other in sense of ligand touching.
Yes, Alex.
I have two questions. I mean, it's a beautiful talk that, you know. I have two questions. The first one is that when I look at this tunneling, that all this mobility that basically goes through tunnels. No, no, go back. It's great. The conclusions is fine.
Ah, yes, it is.
So, I mean, I'm just trying to understand a little better the formula. I mean, where is the temperature here?
So this is analysis overlap integral between two it's quantum mechanic characteristic.
But if you compare so this is how the mobility changes with the length of the ligand. So you would expect that when you go to sufficiently high temperatures, it basically becomes zero, no?
So
the overlap is a property of the wave function of the basis.
The overlap integral would be still critical parameter for hopping of formation of band. So in all the transport problem, if you study quantum dots, array or not array, alloy, the hopping integral is critical parameter for hopping conductivity or band conductivity, because band also controlled by the same overlap integral.
The hopping integral is a property of the electronic Hamiltonian, and you're thinking of what the phonons
But
are
if
doing.
You want to study mobility, mobility would depend on temperature, etc. But what most of my thing, which I try to show, it is overlap integral, which control both hopping conductivity and band waves.
Okay, and then you have not derived a similar formula for the perovskite, have you?
For
when you discuss the perovskite?
No, we didn't discuss the same formula for perovskite.
Sasha, very nice. I want to ask about the overlap integral dependence on the length. So, for example, not the distance. So let's say you go, one model is a sphere, then it has this distance. The other one was we had platelets. Then it's not just distance, it's also the area of contact is much larger than in two spheres. Now, what about in between? You have like, let's say, faceted particles. So then you have face-to-face, that would be perhaps intermediate. You have some comment on how the overlap integral depends on this geometrical consideration of moving from sphere to platelet, so to speak, if you know what I mean?
Unfortunately, I don't know answer this question.
Okay.
We try to investigate the ligand which is not parallel to each other.
Mm-hmm.
Although for nanoplatelets, they really like
nanoplatelet is nice.
In nanocrystals, it is not. And we didn't find good answer, but and other people didn't find good answer. This Dimitalapin paper maybe knows this,
mm-hmm.
the how this hair range. But one thing in the favor of this parallel consideration, because everything exponentially depends. Overlap is exponentially dependent on the distance.
Yeah.
So as soon as you increase this path,
yeah,
you're losing conductivity from sure. this channel. But so still make conductivity should go in the between nanocrystal if they align to each other.
Yeah, thank you.
So maybe a general question. So you showed that, yes, as ligand length increases, the overlap integral drastically decreases. Yeah. So you want to bring nanocrystals?
It's special ligand. It's carboxyl chain ligand,
mm-hmm.
which
mm-hmm.
is generally straight line and can be different lengths.
So you want to bring dots closer and closer, but then on other extreme, you essentially fuse them together and form a bulk. So I think my question is there some, what's the significance of this region before dots become bulk, but still, you know, or very close to each other? Like, is there some interesting property or?
No, it is absolutely clear what Uri told us about the snag formation. In some way, what Uri told us before, it is the same type of idea. You want to increase coupling between quantum dots. And for this, he introduced, like we introduced, semiconductor matrix, which allow to increase this overlap integral. And you need to describe how the coupling through the small neck. And I believe there was some paper on this topic from Boris Shklovsky on silicon. How this coupling depends on the neck of two quantum dots touching each other.
There's one significant difference from Uri's work, which I think is the future, and using linkers or soft matter, which is, and maybe it comes to something that you've basically hidden in your approach in this scattering time, which doesn't tell you any details about, contains, I assume, the electron-phonon coupling, but doesn't tell you any atomistic, mechanistic of how that time comes in. But in terms of merging quantum dots within inorganic material, it's likely to be much better transport because of the coupling to the phonons and the fact that they're localized, and also because you can devise such systems with very low strain. So,
no, it is clear the necking of quantum dot would be the best way to increase
exactly
mobility. Is there no disagreement on this point of view? Because when you're touching nanocrystal, which I show maximum conductivity when you don't have ligand. And another part of this discussion was presented by Dima on the first day. We show that if he put some metal ion between two nanocrystals, somehow he reduces this band offset. It's all about reducing of the band offset between intermediate and
But at the same time, maintaining an offset so that you still have an optical character of the building blocks, because if they're equal, the electron would leak and you wouldn't have the same optical properties.
So in some way, it is an internal contradiction. You want to have optical property. For this, you need to have strong confinement, right? And can regulate optical property. On the other hand, you want to have transport, right? It's clear that in order to have transport, you need to overcome this potential barrier. Exactly. And I think one idea exists how to overcome it. It's actually first paper of Victor Klimov, which shows that if you put nanocrystal on the surface of quantum well, you can have transition of the excitation to the quantum well, they move fluently, right? But it is also a technical issue. But again, it is a, more or less it's all discussion how we can kill this potential barrier one way or another.
Let's take the last question before we break for a coffee.
Yeah, I have the following question. So throughout this calculation, you essentially assumed everything to be quite uniform. So pretty much any contact the same, but clearly it's not the case, right? So and there's ideal, right? Such a big dependence on what's happening there, how this would affect the optical properties or anything else with this heterogeneity.
So calculation of transport was conducted assuming that all the fluctuation was the order 5% of size fluctuation and displacement size. So this allow us to get mobility of Cherenkov and 30 electron volt per, I forgot for units. But in reality, we really, how good we are known. People know that you have an ensemble of array of quantum shift of photoluminescence, which from this shift of luminescence, you can in generally obtain what the larger size of Nagel, how different from the average size.
Yeah.
And this, again, it depends. Initially, I remember initial claim of Chris Murray, the self-organization could occur only dispersion of nanocrystal size of less than 5%. I don't know if he keep this statement right now or not.
To get an order level.
Other they don't self-organize.
All right. Let's thank Sasha again. And we're taking a half an hour break.